Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Vortex, where lies and falsehoods are trapped and exposed. I'm Michael Voris. Saint Benedict, named the patron saint of Europe by Pope Paul VI, was the single individual responsible for laying the groundwork for the creation of Europe from the rubble of the Roman Empire. 1,500 plus years later, another Benedict has arrived with the same mission. When Cardinal Joseph Ratzinger chose the name Benedict upon his election as Pope 5 years ago, he clearly had something in mind. Europe, fashioned by Catholicism, born from Catholicism, is in ruins. This was the point of the Holy Father's address at Regensburg nearly 4 years ago. It was this address at the former university where he was a professor that many in the Muslim world reacted so indignantly to when he quoted a 14th century Byzantine emperor's assessment of Islam being spread through violence. The Pope used that 600-year-old assessment as an example to show that something which goes against reason is contrary to God. He also expanded on the idea of reason and said that modern man in the West, in Catholic Europe, has lost his moral sense because he has reduced reason to a purely scientific empirical formula and by so doing has totally missed the point. Theology and true philosophy, he noted, have come to be viewed as simple areas of study in relation to cultures and as such have simply been relegated to areas of meaningless academic pursuits with no practical application in contemporary society. The Holy Father's observations are spot on. Modern man wants scientific proof and certainty in matters of faith and seeks to relegate all moral decisions to a realm of the subjective based on our technological ability to manipulate matter to our own ends. How we employ the newly devised technologies can never be judged against theological standards, according to contemporary culture. Religion and philosophy simply cannot address such complexities, they say. But it is precisely the order from theology, expressed in authentic philosophical terms, that explains and gives meaning to these advancements of man. The Holy Father rightly points to the opening lines of St. John's Gospel, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God." The Greek term for Word is logos, meaning order and wisdom, the opposite of chaos. God is order and wisdom, and without Him, modern man is doomed to be enslaved by his own marvelous technological achievements and mastery of the material world. We've seen this repeatedly. Modern man has, for example, learned to master the complexities of the human reproductive system and collapse all of his mastery and knowledge into a single pill, and nothing has issued forth from it except death and social disorder. This Pope, this Benedict, stands in the breach of a new dark age, not very unlike Saint Benedict did in the 5th century, and calls on Europe to be reborn and with it all of Western civilization. For this, he is castigated and assailed by the barbarians of the 21st century, bent on laying waste to everything of the prior order. In times of societal turmoil in Europe, Catholic Europe, it has always been a pope which has led the way back from the precipice. Tu es Petrus, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. The church is not dependent on Europe's survival, but Europe's survival is dependent on the church, and with Europe, the whole of Western civilization. This was the message of Regensburg, and predictably, it was totally missed by self-absorbed modern man, thus proving the Holy Father right before even the echo of his words had fallen silent. We provided a link to Pope Benedict's speech at Regensburg right over here. Please read it for yourself. It's masterful. For this talk, for his Regensburg address, international pandemonium broke out, first in Islamic nations, and then in the West, in the media's reaction to the Islamic world's reaction. And standing there in the fog of this war was the Holy Father, his point being made ever so neatly for him that without reason understood properly, man will live in chaos and bring ruin down on himself. Regensburg was no colossal failure of Benedict's papacy, as the secular media have claimed. That such a claim could even be made reveals the intellectual depravity to which Western man has sunk. Regensburg was a clarion call on the part of the successor of St. Peter for Western man, who has relegated the God of reason to the realm of the medieval, to begin his return to him. Tomorrow, in the Vortex, Pope Benedict begins cleaning house. I'm Michael Voris.
Please help us keep delivering these kinds of messages that so desperately need to be heard and acted on. Join RealCatholicTV.com today as a premium subscriber. Become immersed in the faith established by Jesus Christ. The Catholic Church is the only hope against evil because that is its God-given mission. As our Lord said, apart from me, you can do nothing. Join RealCatholicTV.com today as a premium subscriber and come to learn and love Christ more deeply.